A pretty good problem coming up here. The first thing that I'm going to do is factor a 2 out of the numerator and pull it outside. And now, as I always say, whatever you choose for u, there better be a du in your integral somewhere. If I choose e to the 2x as my u, then I better have an e to the 2x somewhere else in the integral for my du. The same is true for e to the 10x. But neither one of these is the case. So I think we have to be a little bit sneaky here, and notice that we can split this numerator up into two pieces. If I do that, I get e to the 10x divided by e to the 2x in my first term, which just turns into e to the 8x because I can subtract these powers. And the second term, 1 over e to the 2x, can be written as e to the negative 2x. And we have two integrals that I think we can complete. Technically, each one of these integrals involves a small u substitution. For the first integral, we would make u 8x, eventually making dx 1 eighth du. In the second integral, our u substitution would be u equals negative 2x, making our du negative 2dx, and our dx negative 1 half du. The effect of these u substitutions is essentially just to divide the first integral by 8 and the second integral by negative 2. Now, I've mentioned this in previous videos, so I think that we can just do it. Our first integral is just going to end up being 1 eighth e to the 8x evaluated from 0 to 1, and the second integral is just going to be negative 1 half e to the negative 2x evaluated from 0 to 1. Let's simplify for a step. Since both of these integrals are now complete and we want to evaluate both of them from 0 to 1, I can combine them into one function evaluated from 0 to 1. We plug in our upper limit of integration. Replacing x with 1 gives us this term right here. And then we subtract, and we plug in x equals 0. Simplifying just a bit, and recalling that anything to the 0 power is just 1. So we have 1 fourth plus 1 here, which is 5 fourths. That gets subtracted, and I think we have ourselves a pretty nice final answer. All right, that problem was a reminder to not forget your algebra skills. Let's get some more practice in the next one.